Good afternoon, everybody. We are back at Ray and B. Dillard Field, Bomar Family Stadium, for the third and deciding game of this NCAA Division II Southeast Super Regional. What would postseason baseball be without a little drama and a winner-take-all matchup to see who goes to the College World Series? That's what we've got here today. After both teams came back to get wins over the opposing team's closer, North Greenville did it yesterday. Columbus State did it in game one today. Isaac Boughton's walk-off three-run home run wins it for the Cougars, 4-3. You're seeing some of the highlights of the first game. And basically after that, it was Pat Monte's three-run home run to right center field that made it a 3-1 game, and that's the way it stood until the bottom of the ninth when Isaac Boughton took Tristan Hudson deep. Starting lineup for Columbus State, the same for the last two games. Isaac Boughton leads it off at short. Colby Brabston, the DH. Robert Brooks hits third. He's the catcher. Stephen Minter will be at first base batting cleanup. David Meadows at third will hit number five, hitting sixth in right field, Derek Wiley. The seven hitter is left fielder Wynn Johns. Matthew McDade at second base bats eighth. And hitting ninth in center field, Connor Curley. On the mound, Devin Dudall. More about him coming up in just a bit. Michael Rodriguez gets the start for North Greenville today. The left-hander is a redshirt sophomore, 6'6", 245 out of Odessa, Florida. Started his career at St. Petersburg College. He is making his ninth start, his 13th appearance, 2-0, 4.24 earned run average, 17 innings is all he's gone. 15 hits, 13 runs, only 8 earned, 22 strikeouts, 11 walks, and opponents hitting .231 against him. So yesterday it was North Greenville rallying off of Peyton Burton. The Columbus State closer in game one today, it was Columbus State turning the trick on Tristan Hudson. So here we go. One game. Winner moves on to the College World Series. The loser begins working on 2023. Good to have you with us here in Tigerville. I'm Dan Scott. Let's play baseball. Isaac Boughton, last time he swung the bat, a three-run home run to win the game. And Michael Rodriguez will work from the stretch. The lefty's first pitch is high, ball one, and we are officially underway at 3:59 p.m., our first pitch time here in Tigerville. Umpires, Trevor Henson behind the plate, Kevin Spivey at first, Gary Keller at second, Bobby Dunnigan at third, and Rodriguez misses badly outside, two balls and no strikes. Boughton, Brabston, and Brooks. Top third of the batting order for Columbus State. Mentioned Rodriguez, this is ninth start and 13th appearance, but only 17 innings on the season. There's a one hopper to first base. Zara was playing wide of the bag. He'll take it himself. And Boughton is retired for the first out. Defensively for the Crusaders, Zara at first, joined on the infield by Garrick Octavio at second, Corey Bibbins at short, Pat Monteith at third. Left to right in the outfield, Ethan Stringer, Josh Center at Mark Kloop, and Jax Cash back behind the plate. One out for Colby Brabston. 276. And the DH is 0-9 in this Super Regional, and he takes strike one. 10 homers and 38 runs batted in. Lefty versus left-handed batter. And a swing and a miss. And Rodriguez quickly ahead in the count. No balls and two strikes. With the 0-2 count, they'll go into the shift for the left-handed batter. Rodriguez dealing, and it's hit to the left side. Monteith, the only defender over there, and his throw is late. He was playing almost the regular shortstop position. The ball was not hit hard. He had to go to his right and get it. And Brabson beat it out for an infield base hit. His first hit of this Super Regional, and now here's Robert Brooks. Well, they have kept the lid on this guy as well, 0 for 7. He's been on twice, a walk, and he's been hit by a pitch. You know his numbers, 381, 21 homers, 83 runs batted in. And he is back behind the plate for the second game today. First pitch to him is outside a ball. Rodriguez with the set and the 1-0 pitch. Swing and a miss. Brooks was trying to make it 2-0. One ball, one strike. Steven Minner, the cleanup hitter on deck. Short lead at first for Brabston, the 1-1. Backdoor breaking ball, strike two called on the outside corner. And Rodriguez ahead at a ball and two strikes. One out, one on, top of the first. The 1-2 upstairs with the fastball. 2-2. Actually giving him a lot of room in left center field. This 2-2 pitch from Rodriguez on the way. And strike three called inside corner with a fastball. Brooks is gone. Two down, first strikeout for Rodriguez, and now the aforementioned Steven Minner, the cleanup hitter. One for eight with an RBI in the first two games. His 70th of the year. 14 homers, a .368 batting average. And Rodriguez bringing the first pitch plateward, and it's grounded to Bivens at short. He'll underhand to Octavio at second. They force Brabston, and the inning is over. 6-4 on the out. Infield single by Brabston, and that's all. And we head to the bottom of the first. Columbus State nothing. North Greenville coming to bat. North Greenville batting order here in game number two today, third game of the series. Garrick Octavio leads it off at second. Ethan Stringer in left, batting second. Pat Monteith will play third and hit third. The cleanup hitter is right fielder Marek Kloop. Josh Center will bat fifth. He's in center field. Zach Zara, the first baseman, hits sixth. Andrew Kaminsky gets the call at DH in this one in the seven hole. Batting eighth and catching, Jax Cash. And at shortstop, batting ninth, Corey Bivens. On the mound, second-team all-conference performer for Columbus State, Devin Dudall, senior, 6'2", 200 pounds, Sterling Heights, Michigan, out of Macomb Community College originally. On the year, his 17th start, 8-5 and a .443 earned run average, has one complete game, 83 and a third innings, 84 hits, 50 runs, 41 earned, 91 strikeouts to just 29 walks, and opponents hitting .257 against him. Looking inside his numbers, has allowed the second most home runs on the team with 10. and has hit the second most number of batters with nine. Garrett Octavio will lead it off. Two for 10 with an RBI, hitting 335 overall, a home run, 27 runs batted in. In the first game, both teams squandered multiple scoring opportunities. And in both the eighth and the ninth, North Greenville had opportunities to add to that 3-1 lead and couldn't. So it'll be interesting in this game to watch and see how both of these teams are able to take advantage, if they are, of scoring opportunities. Dudall delivered the first pitch down and in for a ball. He works from the stretch full time. And the 1-0 to Octavio is high. Two balls and no strikes. Watching Octavio in the batter's box, he is constant motion. Waiting for the 2-0 pitch. And a strike on the inside corner. 2-1. Outfield straight away. Third baseman Meadows pulled in even with the bag. 2-1 pitch. And he slaps it the other way into left field, a base hit. The leadoff single for Garrett Octavio. That'll bring Ethan Stringer to the plate defensively. Steven Metter, Matthew McDade, Isaac Boughton, David Meadows, first, second, short, and third. In the outfield left to right, Wynn Johns, Connor Curley, Derek Wiley, Robert Brooks behind the plate. The lineup, the defensive alignment has been the same for Columbus State all three games. Only the starting pitcher has differed. Now Ethan Stringer. Swings and misses at the first pitch. 3-for-9 with an RBI. 315 the season average. Five homers and 34 runs batted in. He's down a strike. Throw to first and Octavio diving back to the bag. Well, the storylines that we gave you at the beginning of the first game today still hold true in this one. Here's the 0-1 pitch outside, ball and a strike. Columbus State looking for its fifth trip to the College World Series under 25th-year head coach Greg Appleton. North Greenville looking for the first in program history. And incidentally, one thing we failed to mention last game, and regardless of what happens in this game three today, it will still hold true for Columbus State. Stringer, a high one hopper that Meadows kicks, and it rolls out behind him into short left field. That'll be his ninth error of the season. Reaching above his head, and I think he just tried to pick it and throw it before he got it. Two on with nobody out for Pat Monty. But where I was going is that regardless of what happens in this game, Columbus State, this entire season, has not lost back-to-back games. And, of course, by winning the first game today, should they lose this one, they still will not have lost back-to-back games all year. That's pretty incredible when you think about it. Monteith hit the three-run home run in game one today, and he tries to bunt a breaking ball and comes up empty. 3-for-10 with that homer and three runs batted in. Has struck out four times in the first two games. Marek Kloop in the on-deck circle. Octavio at second. He singled. Stringer at first. He reached on an error. Nobody out. The 0-1. He's squaring again and takes a strike on the outside corner of fastball. No balls and two strikes. So Monteith in a two-strike hole. He'll be swinging now. The 0-2 pitch to him, and he pulls it foul. No balls and two strikes to count holding. 81 degrees, our game time temperature for this second game. Sunshine, a few clouds. Octavio bouncing off the bag at second, the 0-2 pitch, and Monteith hits it in the air down the right field line. He hit it deep, and it's gone. Opposite field, three-run home run for Monteith. His second in as many games. And North Greenville jumps out on top, 3-0. And again, stayed on it, hit it hard the other way. His 13th of the season, now 51 RBIs. The 11th home run that Doudal has given up on the year. And now Marek Kloop will bat. He's 2-for-10. And he takes a breaking ball, and he lines it into left field, a base hit. That one hung up there. So Doudal has yet to retire a hitter. And now Josh Center will step in. Should have gotten an out on the big bounding ball off the bat of Stringer to the third baseman Meadows. So of the three runs, one of them unearned. And now Josh Center, runner at first goes. Pitch is taken for a ball. The throw down is not in time. And Boughton, the shortstop, was late getting there. Stolen base for Kloop. His second of the series, his 28th of the season. He's only been caught twice. Josh Center 3-for-7, including a triple in the series, and now chance to drive in a run. The 1-0 in the dirt, two balls and no strikes. Kind of already glancing down to their bullpen. Nobody down there right now. But the leash for both starters, for everybody in this game, will be the shortest of short leashes. Two balls and no strikes to Center. And that's low ball three. 3-0. So Center a pitch away from reaching base. Zach Zara waiting on deck. Doudal's 3-0, and Center takes it right down the middle. 3-1. Outfield straight away. The 3-1 pitch, breaking ball, strike two call, dropped on the inside corner. Center was bailing on it. Doudal's come back to run it full at 3-2. Kloop leading at second base. Nobody out. Three runs in the bottom of the first. Payoff pitch to Center, and he struck him out swinging with a good breaking ball. One out. And now Zach Zara, hitting an even 300 on the season. Three for nine with a double in this super regional. Left-handed batter. And Doudal's first pitch to him. In the dirt, and it gets through all the way to the backstop, and Kloop will move up to third. So a wild pitch. It's the seventh wild pitch of the year for Doudal. Corner infielders are going to come in a bit. The middle infield will stay back here in the first inning. One ball, no strikes. Pitch to Zara. Breaking ball stays outside. 2-0. Left-handed. left-handed batter waiting. Doodall gets the sign, the 2-0 pitch, and he swung at a pitch down and in and fouled it off the catcher, Brooks. Ricocheted all the way over to the first base dugout, 2-1. Good breaking ball dropped on the outside corner. 2-2 the count. Two balls, two strikes. Zara waiting the pitch, and a big bounding ball to first, going high to get it was Metter. And because he was pulled in a step inside the bag, they get the out without Kloop scoring from third. Two down. Three unassisted. Andrew Kaminsky will bat for the first time in this Super Regional. Jordan Holliday started in the DH spot the first two games. Kaminsky hitting .357. Limited time, a home run, seven runs batted in. And he takes a breaking ball for a strike. So Doudal living with that breaking ball as his most effective pitch here in the bottom of the first inning. 3-0 North Greenville, and another runner at third with two down. And that fastball down and away. 1-1. You know, the interesting thing about each team's rally in the first two games of this series, breaking ball low. Yesterday, for North Greenville, it started with the bottom part of the order in the ninth inning. Got to the top and got the back-to-back two-out run scoring hits from Octavio and Stringer to tie the game. In the first game today, you're thinking, well, you got through Brooks, you got through Wiley in the eighth, but it was the bottom part of the order for Columbus State that got it going and got it to the top of the order, and Isaac Boughton hit the game-winning three-run home run. So just when you think you know in this game, the game will tell you that you don't. 2-2 on Kaminsky. Kloop at third, two down. Break-even pitch. Fastball outside, ball three. Normally, you go to the plate looking fastball and adjust. If I'm Kaminsky, I'm almost tempted to be thinking breaking ball on this 3-2 pitch. Here it comes, and it was the breaking ball, and he bounced it foul outside of third. Holding it 3-2. Kaminsky trying to bring in the fourth run of the inning. Doudal trying to limit the damage to the three-run homer. Again, the 3-2 pitch, and the breaking ball missed outside, ball four. So Kaminsky works a two-out walk, and now Jax Cash will bat. He started yesterday, went 0-2 before being pinch hit for. .335 on the year. He's homered three times, knocked in 24. He is the eighth man to bat in the inning. Runners on the corners and two down. And the first pitch to him is a fastball low, ball one. That's the 31st pitch of this first inning, by the way, for Devin Doudal. The 1-0, low and away, two balls and no strikes. Robert Brooks, the catcher, looking into the dugout to get the signs. Now Dude already with the 2-0, and it's ball three, and he missed badly outside. Corey Bibbins, the number nine hitter on deck. 3-0 the count to Jax Cash. Kloop at third, Kaminsky at first, two down, three runs in. And strike one called at the knees. Three and one on Cash. Dudall bringing it, and he walked him in the dirt. And the bases are loaded. Back-to-back walks. And that's going to get Greg Appleton, the head coach, out of the dugout. They haven't had anybody warming up. It looks like the young man that we saw warming up in the first game, lefty Logan Seehafer, is going down to start throwing. He may not be the only one. Appleton, the 25th year head coach, so many accolades. Talked about it yesterday in the opening game, a guy who now has won 898 games as the head coach of this Columbus State program, 1,025 overall. National champ in 2002, runner-up in 07 and 12, 12 NCAA tournament appearances, four times under his watch to the D2 World Series. It's been an incredible career. And I really liked his post-game press conference yesterday when talking about the way they set it up and going to the closer. He said, hey, it's what we've done all year. No reason to change. It just didn't work out this time. Here's Bibbins, and he takes it low for a ball. Two-out base hit right here could really inflict some damage. Already 3-0 in the first. Bibbins 2-for-8 in this series. Teammates at every base with two down. The 1-0, and he bounced a breaking ball. Two balls and no strikes. Bibbins hitting 330 with 11 home runs and 48 RBIs. Two balls and no strikes. You can really be selective here. Think one pitch, one zone. If you don't get it, wait. And he got a fastball down the pipe, and he fouled it off. 2-1. Inning began with Octavio singling. Stringer reached on an error. Monteith, an opposite field three-run home run. Kloop singled. Stole second. Center struck out. Zara bounced out, but then Kaminsky and Cash walked back-to-back to load the bases. And now it's 3-1 on Bivens with no place to put him. The leadoff hitter, Garrick Octavio, on deck. Here's the 3-1 on the way. Swing and a miss. So they'll be running all over the place. Kloop from third, Kaminsky from second, Cash from first. With two down and a three-ball, two-strike count on Corey Bivens. Here's the payoff. The runners go, and it's outside ball four to force in a run. Kloop scores. It's a 4-0 North Greenville lead. That also an unearned run. Kaminsky to third, Cash to second, and for Bibbins, his 49th run batted in of the season. And now Garrick Octavio, who started this inning, will bat again. He singled and was on base along with Stringer when Monteith hit the home run. And he takes it down and in a ball. And right now, the strike zone, the plate, as someone once said, is jumping all over the place on Devin Dudall. He has walked three consecutive hitters with two outs to force in a run. 4-0 North Greenville here in the first. The 1-0 to Octavio. Strike one called on the outside corner. 1-1. You've got good speed all over the base paths. Anything into a gap here likely is going to clear the bases. The 1-1 pitch. Upstairs, two balls and a strike. It's been a four-run first inning. A long, long first inning. The 2-1 to Octavio. And he lines it into center field, a base hit. Here comes Kaminsky. Here comes Jax Cash. The throw cut off, and they go to third. And they got the tag on the runner, Bivens. The ball was dropped and then picked up by Meadows. Inning is over, but a six-run first inning. A two-run single for Octavio. And after one, 6-0 North Greenville. Now we go to the top of the second inning. Michael Rodriguez now has a six-run lead to protect. And my Czech Republic correspondent is telling me that North Greenville this season is 32-4 when they score first. We have seen a lot of trends bucked in the first two games of this series, but a 6-0 lead for the Crusaders, and Rodriguez will go to work on 5, 6, and 7, Meadows, Wiley, and Johns. David Meadows is 5-for-8 in this series with an RBI. And Rodriguez out of the stretch, the first pitch to him is swung on and fouled back. It'll be interesting to see what their plan is with Rodriguez. We may already have the answer because someone is throwing in the bullpen for North Greenville. So it may be a two-inning opener type situation for Rodriguez. Meadows hitting 345 overall, and that pitch misses badly inside and all the way to the backstop. 1-1. A six-run bottom of the first inning for North Greenville. They lead it 6-0. And two balls and a strike. He's talking to Eddie Tobinsey between games after the walk-off homer by Boughton. He stopped by the booth to say hello and ask him how he was doing. And he said, well, you know, obviously nerves every game, but this one coming up now, probably the most nervous because this is the one that his son will probably pitch in. Three balls and a strike. Rodriguez missed high with that pitch. And he walked him. Not what you want to do with a six-run lead. Walk the leadoff guy. Now Derek Wiley. Had a good series so far, 4-for-9 with a home run and three runs batted in. The homer was his 19th of the season. 67 RBIs and a 344 batting average for the sophomore. the first pitch from Rodriguez got the outside corner a strike. Right-handed batter. Long pause, the 0-1. Breaking ball stayed high and away. One ball, one strike. They are in the shift for the right-handed hitter. Here's the 1-1. Big swing. He was right on a fastball and fouled it straight back. 1-2. Now Rodriguez will step off. Meadows at first. He walked leading off the inning. 1-2 on Wiley. And the lefty bringing it. And the breaking ball doesn't. Spins and stays outside. 2-2. Two and two the count on Wiley. Break even pitch. Tried the corner again and missed. By the way, if you're scoring, I don't know if anybody else does or not. It's becoming a lost art. But if you are, the out on Bibbins for the final out of the inning was 8-1-5. Center fielder to pitcher to third baseman. 3-2 on Derek Wiley. Rodriguez with the payoff, and he struck him out swinging. Probably swung at ball four. Pitch up in the zone, one out. Now Wynn Johns. 2-for-9 with an RBI, 329 on the season. One on, one out, top of the second inning. 6-0 North Greenville. First pitch from Rodriguez is tapped foul behind the plate. No balls and a strike. Strike two called. Inside corner with a fastball, and Rodriguez jumps out ahead of Johns, 0-2. Right-handed batter waiting. The 0-2 pitch up high. One ball and two strikes. Matthew McDade waiting on deck. Rodriguez bringing it, and he missed outside again. Two and two. Walk Meadows. Struck out Wiley on a 3-2 pitch. He's deep in the count on Johns. Ready to throw a 2-2 pitch. Here it is. And it's pop foul. That'll get back out of play. Holding it 2-2. John's waiting. And Rodriguez bringing the break even. And another foul out of play. Trevor Henson, the home plate umpire, takes delivery of a new supply of baseballs. 2-2 and holding on Wynn Johns. Rodriguez with the set. And for the third time, the break-even pitch. And it's fouled away down the right field line. So Rodriguez throwing strikes. John's fouling him away. And a fourth 2-2 pitch coming. And he missed outside. Tried that backdoor breaking ball again. It's 3-2. Three balls, two strikes. See if the runner's moving. I doubt it. Down six with one out. Payoff pitch. And a fly ball to right. Kloop calling and catching as he moves toward the gap. Two down. For a minute, he threw both arms out. I couldn't tell if he was being emphatic about the call or if he lost the baseball. But it's a routine out. And now here's Matthew McDade. One hit in seven trips through the first two games. 267 on the season. Freshman second baseman, and he pulls it foul, third base side. No balls and a strike. Six nothing North Greenville as we play here top of the second inning. Pitch a little bit upstairs. Rodriguez didn't get the call. It looks like he came out of his shoe. Or did he hurt himself? He is, looks like he's done something maybe to his left leg. He is limping. And the training staff going to go out. He's reaching for his calf. I don't know if maybe he's pulled a muscle or what, but he's limping down the mound. Yeah, he's got a cramp. That's what he's got. He is lying flat on his back, and the trainer's got that leg extended, the toe bending backwards, and they're trying to work that cramp out. So a break in the action while they tend to Michael Rodriguez with two outs here in the top of the second inning. Runner at first for Columbus State. North Greenville leading 6-0. They bring him some water out. It's going to be difficult for him to drink it lying flat on his back. Just open your mouth, man. I'll pour it in from about 3 feet above. See how much gets in there. They're still working that cramp out. If the plan was for him to go two innings, he's one out away from getting there. You know they'd love for him to finish it. They're still working to try to get that cramp out. Still pushing that toe back. Landon Powell, nothing he can do except sit and watch the trainer work. Tell you what, this is as extended a working out of a cramp as I have seen in a long time. And I'm trying to remember the last one I saw on the baseball field. Normally, where you see most of them is early in the college football season. I can't remember the last one I saw from a baseball standpoint, but this must be a doozy because he is still down. They are still pushing that toe back, trying to get that thing to release. And I think this is the longest time I've ever done play-by-play of the working out of a cramp. Now Rodriguez is up. Now he'll take the water. Speaking of Eddie Tobinsey a little earlier, break up my Cincinnati Reds. After the 3-22 start, they've gone 12-9 since. They've won three in a row, and they're up 3-0 on the Giants early today. Good will prevail over evil. Here's another look. Watch what Rodriguez does after this pitch. As soon as that left leg hit the ground, he reached for that calf. And he is still struggling out there. I don't know if he's going to be able to finish this. He's not. Landon Powell has already signaled to the bullpen. So they're going to have to make a pitching change. Perhaps an out earlier than they wanted to, and Rodriguez is going to gingerly make his way toward the first base dugout. And we've got ourselves an early break in the action here, and the new pitcher coming on. There are about five people running in out of the North Greenville bullpen. But the one that's veering off toward the mound wears number 20, and that is Thomas Skipper, a freshman right-hander. Skipper, 5'9", 180-pounder out of Marion, South Carolina. He'll come on here in the top of the second inning with two outs and a runner on, inheriting a 1-1 count. This will be his 16th appearance on relief, 2-1 and a 4.44 earned run average. Has pitched 26 and a third innings in his freshman campaign, 29 hits, 15 runs, 13 earned, 22 strikeouts to just 3 walks. And opposing batters hitting 271 against him. You like that 22-3 strikeout to walk ratio. Rodriguez, inning in two-thirds. One hit, no runs yet. A walk and two strikeouts. And he will end up leaving after throwing 32 pitches, 18 of them for strikes. So an extended break as they tried desperately to work that cramp out of Michael Rodriguez, couldn't get it. So now Skipper comes on. And again, he'll inherit a 1-1 count, so this batter will belong to him regardless of what happens. Had he come in, for instance, with a two-ball count and walked McDade, then that walk would have been charged to Rodriguez. But the count's 1-1, so it'll be Skipper's batter regardless. So he'll get a couple more warm-up tosses. The bottom of the first inning, 6 runs for North Greenville. 3-run homer by Pat Monteith. Bases loaded walk to Corey Bivens. And a 2-out, 2-run single by Garrick Octavio, his second hit of the inning. And then Bivens was thrown out trying to go first to third. All against their second team all-conference starting pitcher, Devin Doodall. All right, here we go. Skipper inherits a 1-ball, 1-strike count on Matthew McDade, the right-handed freshman. Checks the runner at first, comes set. And his 1-1 pitch. Breaking ball, just missed outside, 2-1. Two outs, Meadows at first. He walked leading off this top of the second inning. And a check swing foul on a sidearm fastball that was really bearing in on Matthew McDade. We've been going for 46 minutes, 47 minutes, and we've not yet gotten the third out of the top of the first inning. Or top of the second inning. Runner goes, 2-2 pitch is taken inside a breaking ball, and no chance for Jax Cash. He just held on to the baseball. 3-2 the count. So the count goes full on McDade. Meadows now at second base with two down. Skipper ready with the payoff pitch. Here it comes. And a high fly ball back into left. The scoreboard. 14th home run of the season for McDade. Looked like he got a breaking ball that hung on the inner part of the plate. And it's a 6-2 game. .46 RBIs now for McDade. Got all of that one. So Rodriguez will get charged with one of those runs. Inning of two-thirds, a hit, a run earned, a walk, two strikeouts. And now Connor Curley. Two for five officially. He's walked three times in this series, has a double. Takes ball one, left-handed batting number nine hitter. Skipper's 1-0. Fouled it off his foot, and he goes down in a heap at the plate. Now he gets up and will hobble up the first baseline to try to get the bees to quit buzzing out of that right foot or ankle. Jumping up and down. I mean, he went down, the bat went flying. The limp is gone. He'll be feeling that one for a little bit. One ball and one strike to him. Two outs. Two-run homer by McDade has Columbus State on the board. They trail 6-2. Top of the second inning. Skipper with the 1-1. Strike two called on the outside corner. That was the third home run Skipper's allowed this year, by the way. With the count 1-2, they'll go into the shift now for the left-handed batter. And he asks for time. Here comes the 1-2. Breaking ball, and it's lifted down the left field line, but that'll get foul and out of play. Continuing to hold it, a ball and two strikes. Skipper pitching, and it's lined back into right, but Kloop got a good jump on it and reaches up and makes the catch just shy of the warning track. Curley hit it pretty good, but Marek Kloop was there to make the catch. Inning is over. They get two runs on the homer by McDade, and in the middle of the second, it is 6-2 North Greenville. Bottom of the second, Columbus State has gone to its bullpen and bringing on left-hander Logan Seehafer. 5'9", 170-pound sophomore from Hampton, Georgia, started off at Andrew Community College. On the season, Seehafer making his 24th appearance, all in relief. He's 1-0 and a 5.08 earned run average, has four of their 10 saves. 28 in the third innings, 18 hits, 16 runs all earned. 31 strikeouts, 14 walks. Has given up five home runs in those 28 and a third innings. Opponents hitting 176 against him. So when he gets it over, he's been fairly successful. But averaging one walk every two innings. Young left-hander comes on replacing Devin Dudal. Who goes an inning, four hits, six runs, only two earned. Three walks and a strikeout through 45 pitches. And of those 45, 23 were strikes. Ethan Stringer will lead it off. He reached on an error, and he was on base along with Octavio when Monteith hit the three-run home run in the first. Seehafer's first pitch is down and in a ball to the right-handed batter. One ball and no strikes. Stringer, Monteith, and Kloop. 2-3-4. And there's a strike on the inside corner. 1-1. Outfield straight away. Meadows a step behind the bag at third. And Stringer, fly ball to center. Waiting on it is Curley. He's got it. And there's one out. Now Monteith hit his second three-run home run in as many games. In the first inning, he had tried to bunt on the first two pitches with runners at first and second, nobody out. Failed. It was a no-ball, two-strike count. Ended up getting a pitch on the outer part of the plate, stayed on it, and hit it out of here down the right field line. And that hits him. Pitch down and in. He's on for the second time, and Marek Kloop will bat. Kloop singled after the Monteith home run. Eventually came in to score when Bivens drew the third straight walk that Dudal issued to force in a run. That made it 4-0, and then Octavio would drive in the last two with a bases-loaded single. First pitch to Kloop. Fastball right down the middle for a strike. 0-1 the count. Outfield straight away for him. Infield back at double play depth. The 0-1. And that pitch just missed, maybe a little bit inside. Ball and a strike. Six to two, North Greenville on top here in the bottom of the second. 1-1, strike two called. Spinning breaking ball that came back just enough to get the outside corner. And Kloop behind 1-2. Josh Center waiting on deck. Seehafer pitching, and Kloop bounces it towards second. 4-6. Three, double play, inning is over. McDade, Boughton, Mitter. So he faces the minimum, hit a batter, erase him on the double play. And after two complete, 6-2 North Greenville.
Since 2009, Division II also has a partnership with Cheese Impact since 2011. Over 500 children with serious or chronic illnesses have been matched with a Division II team. To learn more about Division II community engagement, visit ncaa.org/D2.
Thomas Skipper on for his first full inning of relief. He came on after Rodriguez caught a cramp that he couldn't get rid of with the count 1-1 on McDade. Skipper came on, ended up giving up a two-run homer to McDade before Curley flied out to deep right. So top of the order for Columbus State, Boughton, Brabston, and Brooks. Boughton grounded out to first unassisted his first time up, and that pitch misses outside a ball. Sidearm fastball, tried to bring it back over the corner and didn't get the call from home plate umpire Trevor Henson. The 1-0, and that one missed badly outside. Two balls and no strikes. Young right-hander winds and delivers, and there's a fastball strike, 2-1. Fly ball, center field. Josh Center waiting on it, 1-0. Had a little bit of carry to it, but came up short of the warning track. Now Brabston had an infield single in the first inning. It's his first hit of this Super Regional. Now 1-for-10. And a little one hopper towards Octavio at second. Fields and throws, quickly two down. Now Robert Brooks took a called third strike from Rodriguez in the first inning. He's looking for his first hit in the Super Regional. Go into the shift for him, and Skipper's first pitch. Breaking ball that spins up there high, ball one. And he swings, and he lines one into left field for a base hit. So Brooks gets off the schneid here in the third inning with two outs and nobody on. And that extends the inning for Stephen Minter.
Now batting the first baseman, Stephen Minter.
We got an email from Cheryl Octavio. Gehrig's mom says, "What a day it's been so far, you think?" As was the case yesterday, they got people from all over the Hawaiian Islands who are watching this one today. First pitch to Minter's down and away, a ball. I know in the first game yesterday, we had over 3,100 viewers to the broadcast. Haven't checked the numbers for the first game today. Minter ended the first inning with a fielder's choice ground ball. The 1-0. Swing and a miss. Good breaking ball. said Luke's Pony League coach, Ronnie DeTorio from Kalaheo, Kauai, among those who are zeroed in on us today. 1-1. And a fastball fouled off, drop down sidearm again. It's 1-2. 6-2. North Greenville, 6 in the first. Two-run homer by McDade in the top of the second for Columbus State. Two outs and a runner at first for the Cougars here in the third. Skipper ready with the 1-2 pitch to Steven Minter. And the breaking ball just spun up there. 2-2. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Skipper trying to strand Brooks at first. The break-even pitch. And he struck him out swinging. Breaking ball looked like it backed up on him a little bit. But he got the swing by Minter. First strikeout for Skipper. Inning is over. No runs, a hit, no errors, one left. Middle of the third, still 6-2 North Greenville. Logan Seehafer, his second inning of relief. He'll get 5, 6, and 7 in the North Greenville lineup. Center, Zara and Kaminsky. Josh Center struck out swinging in the first inning. He was the first out in that inning. Seehafer delivers a breaking ball in the outside corner of strike. Sophomore left-hander works from the stretch and center fouls it off first base side. He's behind 0-2. No balls and two strikes. Lefty brings it, and he missed outside. 1-2. Bottom of the third inning, 6-2, North Greenville. Winner take all. For a shot and a trip, rather. Not a shot at, but a trip to the Division II College World Series. Bouncing ball foul, holding it 1-2. Go back to the regionals last week. North Greenville send the spot that Columbus State is in now, where the Crusaders lost the first game to Lenoir Rhine after they had eliminated UNC Pembroke and then had to win two straight to get here. And that's what Columbus State is trying to do in this Super Regional. 2-2 pitch, foul straight back. So both of these teams very familiar with elimination games. Two balls and two strikes. Holding and the pitch. Low ball three. And while North Greenville as a program has never made the NCAA College World Series, it must be pointed out that Landon Powell and Trey Dyson have national champions with the Gamecocks in 2010 and 11. 3-2 pitch, fouled straight back again. And Powell was voted one of the 50 best all-time players in the history of the Rosenblatt Stadium era of College World Series play. So he knows what it takes to get there. But he can't do it for his players. Again, the 3-2 pitch, and it's outside, ball four. That's a great plate appearance by Josh Center. He was down 0-2, fought his way back to full, fouled off a couple of pitches, and draws a leadoff walk. Now Zach Zara bounced out to first in the first inning. Lefty versus left-handed batter. And Seehafer's first pitch is a breaking ball down and away, ball one. They have a submarining right-hander beginning to throw down in their bullpen. Check and see if that's Giannone, who we saw yesterday. There's a strike. It is Leo Giannone, who's been there. Setup guy all season long to get them to Peyton Burton. Rolls go out the window now, though. Both of these head coaches are going to put the best option they have out there to get them onto the next inning. 1-1 pitch to Zara. Long hold by Seehafer, and now time called at the plate. Looks like he had no intention of making that pitch. He was just going to hold it until time was called. The 1-1, and Zara tried to drop down a bunt, and he fouled it into the screen. He was bunting for a base hit. Fouled it off left side. He's behind a ball and two strikes in center. As Seehafer lifted the leg to come to the plate, was moving back toward first base. Did not get a good read on his move. 1-2 on Zara with Kaminsky on deck. He's running now. Pitches in the dirt, and the throw down is not in time. Matter of fact, it went into center field. So Josh Center with a stolen base. 26th of the season. He's been caught twice. He's out there with nobody out. A 2-2 count in this lefty-lefty matchup. Zara's got to do everything he can to, at the very least, try to get him to third. And he lines it foul just outside of third. Shot it the other way. Missed by about 2 feet. 2-2. Six to two North Greenville here in the bottom of the third. Here comes the 2-2 again. And the breaking ball fouled off to the left, out of play. I think that's a pitch he'd like to have again, because that one did more spinning than it did breaking. It kind of hung on the inner part of the plate, and all Zara could do was foul it off. That was not the good breaking ball you want to see in a lefty-lefty matchup. And now time called as Perez Knowles, the pitching coach, is going to come out of the first base dugout and head to the mound. Have I mentioned we're going to be here a while? Nobody is going to get in any kind of hurry with what's on the line in this game. The first one ended in 2 hours and 55 minutes when Boughton hit the game-winning three-run home run in the bottom of the ninth. We're an hour and 14 minutes into this one and still in the bottom of the third. But that's okay. It's going to take as long as it takes. And as I said, neither one of these managers are going to try to play hurry-up baseball. They want to get to the College World Series. 2-2 the count. Break-even pitch again, and it's low and away, ball three. Now, don't get me wrong. I'd much rather have a 2.5-hour game than a 3.5-hour game. Zara has worked the count full. See Hafer ready with the payoff. Center continuing to edge on his lead, and Zara hits it in the air to left. Playing shallow and making the catch is Johns, and there's one out. Now Kaminsky, who walked and scored in the first inning. Giannone is ready should Greg Appleton want to go to him. He's just standing down there now. And the sophomore left-hander's first pitch to Kaminsky is outside, ball one. Center walked leading off the inning, stole second. He's still there with one out. North Greenville on top, 6-2, and Seehafer bluffs back towards second base. Now he's ready in the 1-0 pitch. Checked his swing, and it cost him a strike, 1-1. Outfield is straight away. The infield is back. Second baseman McDade shading toward the bag, trying to keep center close. Now he backs off. The 1-1 pitch, and Kaminsky fouls it right back toward us. We are fully protected, though, by netting on all sides and above. 1-2 the count. This was an issue for the Crusaders, really for both teams, but more so for the Crusaders in game one. Despite taking a 3-1 lead into the ninth inning, they left 10 base runners on, had multiple opportunities to extend the lead, and could never get it done. And Kaminsky strikes out swinging, and they are two down. First strikeout for Seehafer, and now Jax Cash, who walked and scored in the first. So you have center at second with nobody out. He's still there with two out. In the first game, he led off an inning with a triple and ended up being stranded. Talking about Josh Center. So now Cash. And a breaking ball drops in for a strike. Nice pitch by Seehafer. Cash has driven in 24 runs on the season. Looking for a two-out base hit here. Big hole to shoot out on the right side. McDade again backs off the bag, and Seehafer misses low and outside, 1-1. McDade comes toward the bag to try and let Josh Center know he's in the same neighborhood should Seehafer want to throw back that way. And just as he gets ready to pitch, he backs off to his left again. Staring at him is Seehafer. Now the 1-1, and he misses outside. 2-1. Cash has the bat cocked and loaded. Seehafer ready with the 2-1. And it's high, 3-1 with Corey Bivens waiting on deck. Three balls, one strike to Jax Cash. Walked and scored in the first. The 3-1 to him is popped up. Shallow right center field, Wiley or Curley? And Connor Curley, the center fielder, makes the play. And the inning is over. Crusaders miss an opportunity. Runner at second, nobody out, can't get him in. And we've played three innings. 6-2, North Greenville. Back to Tigerville in a moment.
Get involved in activities and experiences outside their sports and engage in all areas that will help them succeed in career and life after college. Make yours in Division II. Visit ncaa.org/D2.
Pound freshman from Orlando, Lake Sumter State Community College is where he started. 16th appearance, his 10th in relief, 2-2, a 5.11 earned run average, has a save. 37 innings, 41 hits, 23 runs, 21 earned, has struck out 49, walked 12, and opponents hitting 289 against him. Thomas Skipper, inning in the third, two hits, a run. It was earned, no walks, and a strikeout. So Tobinsey becomes the third pitcher of the afternoon behind Rodriguez and Skipper. We move on to the fourth inning. Tobinsey will get 5, 6, and 7, Meadows, Wiley, and Johns here in this top of the fourth. 6-2, North Greenville. Meadows walked and scored. He was on base when Skipper gave up the two-run homer to McDade. Tobinsey working from the stretch. Meadows pushes a bunt, first base side of the mound. Tobinsey gets, Fields throws, not in time. Beat it with a head-first slide. Fairly well-placed bunt. Tobinsey did what he could, but Meadows, who can run a little bit, beat it out. And he's a leadoff base runner. Now Derek Wiley, who struck out swinging his first time up. So a mild bit of pressure put on Tobinsey immediately. Umpire stopped play because the music hadn't stopped. Boston was still wafting its way through the speakers. And Tobinsey will throw to first. And for whichever team advances to the College World Series, it will definitely be more than a feeling this afternoon. It'll be a reality. First pitch, and Wiley takes a big hack and comes up empty. No balls and a strike. Tobinsey kicks and throws and fouls it straight back. Got in his fist a little bit, and it's 0-2. No balls, two strikes. Wiley hit his 19th home run yesterday, drove in a run in the first game today. The 0-2, and he struck him out swinging. Three pitches, and see you later. One out. Second time he's gone down, 66th time this season. And now Wynn Johns, who flied to right in the second inning. He was the last official batter that Rodriguez faced. He went 1-1 on McDade, and after the second pitch came up with that cramp, and they just could not get it worked out. Tobinsey will throw to first. And he'll throw to first again. You know, as many games as I've called from here, you'd think that I would be smart enough, knowing what time of day it is, to bring a towel or something. Swing and a miss, because part of the issue here is the glare coming off of this thing with the sun shining right down into the booth. No balls and a strike. You'd think I'd be smart enough to do that. Only have like a dozen of them. The 0-1. Strike two cold on the inside corner. It's no balls and two strikes. 6-2. North Greenville on top. A six-run first inning. After losing on a three-run home run by Isaac Boughton in the bottom of the ninth inning in game one today that forced this winner take all. Ground ball to Bivens at short. He'll get the force at second. The relay to first, not in time. Now, white towel's not going to help too much. I'm chiding myself. I need a great big one. I'll remember next year. Thank you, though. I appreciate your attempt to help. It'll at least take a little bit of the glare off that way. 6-4 on the force of Meadows. Two down, and now the aforementioned McDade, who hit the two-run homer. Actually, that's not bad. High with the fastball, 1-0. Bunt single by Meadows to lead off the inning. He was just erased on the ground ball by Johns. He's at first with two out. Matthew Tobin see his first inning of relief work. The 1-0 and a fly ball. Center field, that's where it went. Josh Center making the play. And the inning is over. We head to the bottom of the fourth. Still 6-2 North Greenville. Bottom of the fourth, and a new pitcher for Columbus State, a guy we saw yesterday, Leo Giannone. Submarining right-hander, a freshman, 6'2", 210 out of Marietta, Georgia, started at Mercer. Yesterday, two innings, a hit, three strikeouts. He was very good. Ready to go to work on Corey Bibbins, the number nine hitter leading it off, and he pulls it hard but foul outside of third. No balls and a strike. And that off-speed breaking ball misses inside. One and one the count. And Bibbins, a flare out into shallow center field. That'll drop for a base hit. Leadoff man aboard. We go back to the top of the order. Garrick Octavio, two for two. Both of those hits came in the first inning. This will be his first at bat since. On cue, Timothy Octavio says a good way to spend a Saturday starting at 0600 hours Hawaii time, watching not one but two North Greenville baseball games. And Octavio takes it, ball one. Six to two, North Greenville on top here in the bottom of the fourth inning. Third and deciding game of the Super Regional. Strike one call to Octavio. And they've got another right-hander warming up down in their bullpen. Zach Brockman, a senior, started his career at Liberty University. Octavio hits a spinning breaking ball, foul, and out of play, left field side. One and two. Ethan Stringer on deck, Pat Monteith in the hole. Bivens at first with the leadoff single here in the bottom of the fourth. The 1-2. And another foul left side. Holding in a ball and two strikes on Octavio. Giannone pitching, and it's outside, ball two. Two and two the count. Left-handed batter waiting. Here comes the break-even pitch. And he struck him out swinging. Pitch up and away. And Octavio couldn't get it. One out. First strikeout for Giannone. And now Stringer, who's reached on an error and scored. And flied to center in two times up.
Now back, the left fielder, Ethan Stringer.
So Stringer waiting, and Giannone with the first pitch to him, and it's grounded toward the shortstop. Backhanded off the glove of Boughton. Out onto the outfield turf. That'll be an error. The 17th of the season on Isaac Boughton. And they have two on to the Crusaders with one out for Pat Monteith, who has hit a three-run home run and been hit by a pitch. He's hit two of those today, one in the first game to right center, the one in the first inning today, about 10 feet fair down the right field line. And he checks on a breaking ball, and it cost him a strike. Again, an opportunity for the Crusaders to add to the lead. First and second, one out. No balls and a strike on Monteith. Pitch, another breaking ball, and that one missed apparently outside. It looked like a pretty good pitch. One and one. Bivens at second. Stringer at first, and Monteith grounds it. Diving stop by Boughton at short to knock it down. Won't get an out. Infield single, and for the moment anyway, has saved a run. If that ball gets through, Bivens is going to score. As it is, he stops at third. Stringer at second, and now Mark Kluke will bat with the bases loaded. He has singled and scored and grounded into a 4-6-3 double play in two times up. So a big opportunity here to add to a four-run lead, and a breaking ball floats in for a strike on the inside corner. Oh and one on Kloop, teammates at every base, one out. 6-2, North Greenville, bottom of the fourth. Giannone pitches, and Kloop fouls it away. He's behind 0-2. Josh Center in the on-deck circle. No balls, two strikes. Loop in a run-producing situation here. Giannone with his back to the wall, the 0-2 pitch, and it's outside, a fastball. 1-2. Got him with a called strike on a sidearm curve or a submarine curve on pitch one, a foul ball on a curve on pitch two. Let's see if he comes back to that. He goes fastball, and it's a high bounding ball to second. They're only going to get an out at first. Having to wait on it was McDade. Bivens will score to make it a 7-2 game. Stringer advances to third, Monteith the second. That's an unearned run, but a run. Kloop his 72nd run batted into the season. So he fought off a 1-2 pitch, was able to get a run in, and now Josh Center with runners at second and third and two down. He has struck out, he has walked, and two times up. And the first pitch is a ground ball to short. Moving to his left is Boughton. He throws out center, and the inning is over. So it could have been worse. Crusaders get a run unearned on two hits, an error, and two left. And after four complete, North Greenville on top, 7-2.
NCAA would like to thank official equipment supplier Drawing, Smitty, and Spec Seats for their support of NCAA Championship. Their contributions help enhance the educational and athletic experiences of nearly 500,000 NCAA student athletes.
Matthew Tobinsey out for his second inning of relief work. And he'll get 9-1-2 in the Columbus State batting order. Curley, Boughton, and Brabston. Tobinsey gave up a bunt single in the last inning, but then got the next three. Curley flied to right his first time. Junior center fielder. And Tobinsey ready to go to work on him, working out of the stretch as he always does, runners on or not. And the first pitch, and there for a strike. Lefty versus left-handed batter. Tobinsey versus Curley. The 0-1. Fastball up. Ball and a strike. The 1-1. Shoots it foul into the screen by the third base dugout. And Tobinsey ahead now, a ball and two strikes. Trying to get Curley to start this fifth inning. The 1-2. And he bounced it up there, 2-2. Did not see Brent Herlong at all in the first game today. He threw an inning yesterday. Just got the feeling they're biding their time with him. Ball three in the dirt. The later you could get him in, the better. Tristan Hudson would not be available after inning and a third today, giving up the game-winning home run after pitching yesterday. 3 balls and 2 strikes. And he walked him, was ahead 0-2 and lost him. So we go back to the top of the order for Boughton, who is 0-2. Ground ball to first, fly ball to center. Thomas, he ready to go to work on the right-handed batting shortstop. And he takes a strike. Second walk issued by Crusader pitching in this game. Rodriguez walked the first batter of the second inning. Toss over to first. That was Meadows, and of course he was on when McDade hit the two-run homer off Skipper. No balls and a strike. And again, the throw to first. And he threw it away. Threw it down the right field line, and that is going to get Curley all the way to third base. Throwing error on the pickoff. And they've got a chance to get that run back that North Greenville scored in the bottom of the fourth inning. Runner at third and nobody out. Kind of a balance sometimes. You want to keep control of the running game to a certain extent, but you've got a 5-run lead. You've got to pay most of your attention to the hitter. Now the runner at third, nobody out. Infield stays back, and there's a strike. It's 0-2 to Boughton. They'll give up the run to get the out here. Brabston on deck, and then Brooks. Tobinsey with the pause and the 0-2 pitch. Upstairs with the fastball. 1-2. Ball and two strikes. Boughton, the hero of game one today. Waiting, Tobinsey pitching. And it hit him. Brushed him on the arm as it went by. And that'll put him at first and third with nobody out. Landon Powell disagreeing with home plate umpire Trevor Henson. Can we see that first base replay angle again from the first base camera? Can you guys show that again in the booth? Here it comes. You see that elbow flap that's sticking out there? That's what it got. Here's a strike to Colby Brabston. If it hit anything, it was that elbow pad that he was wearing that was sticking out beyond the elbow by a couple of inches. No balls and a strike. And that pitch a little bit up, maybe outside, 1-1. So with a 5-run lead, Tobinsey in trouble here. Runners on the corners, nobody out. Top of the fifth inning. Pitch. And he missed high. Two and one. Middle infield back, Monteith. Well off the line, even with the bag at third. Swing and a miss. Brabston late on the fastball. It's 2-2. Brabston 1-for-2 today. Infield single in the first. Grounded the second in the third. 2-2 pitch. And he struck him out swinging. Fastball up and in. He had a little bit of giddy up on those last two pitches. One out, second strikeout for Tobinsey, and now here is Brooks. Got his first hit of the series, his last time up, a single. First and third now in the first game today. He was up in a bases-loaded one-out situation. They're playing him exactly as they are now with Octavio, the second baseman, directly behind the bag. He hit it right to him, and they turned a 4-3 double play to end the inning. They had the bases loaded, nobody out in that inning, and didn't score. And the first pitch, he chops it slowly, left side, charging his Monteith. Only play will be a running throw to first as Curley scores to make it 7-3. At the moment, that's an unearned run. Bouton advances to second. Brooks gets an RBI, his 84th of the season. Two down now. And Stephen Minner will bat. He is 0-for-2, struck out swinging his last time up. Tobinsey trying to limit the damage to that one run. Right-handed batter waiting in the first pitch. And there for a strike. Seven, 6-1 for North Greenville, 3-4-2 for Columbus State. Top of the fifth. The 0-1. Breaking ball in the dirt, a ball and a strike. Tobinsey ready with the 1-1, swing and a miss, fastball up. One and two, Tobinsey trying to get the out. Limit the damage to a run, strand the runner at second. Long pause by the lefty, the 1-2 pitch. And he fouled it straight back. Had a good cut at a fastball. Holding it 1-2. David Meadows on deck. Run in for Columbus State. They trail 7-3 here in the top of the fifth inning. Winner take all, third game of this Super Regional. Tobinsey again with the 1-2 pitch. Upstairs, missed badly up. 2-2. Men are waiting as Tobinsey looks in to get the sign from Jax Cash. Now comes set, and the 2-2 pitch. Grounded left side, cut off by Monteith to his left. His throw low and unable to handle it is Zara. That'll be a throwing error on Monteith, and the inning will continue. That's his 14th error of the season. Good throw, and they've got him easy. He made a nice play ranging to his left. If that ball gets by him, Bibbins has no shot going deep in the hole to backhand. Second error of the inning. And now David Meadows, who has walked and scored, and he was the first batter Tobbets he faced leading off the fourth, had a bunt single. And he takes it upstairs, a ball. You cannot, and this has applied to both teams in the Super Regional, cannot give good teams extra outs and expect not to pay for it at some juncture. The 1-0, swing and a miss. And the thing about it, if Tobinsey doesn't throw that pickoff throw into right field, if the inning plays out the way it did, Monteith has an easy short throw to second base on that ball to get a force, and a run has not scored. 1-1 pitch. Hit in the air, deep left field line on the run, and leaping. Did he get it? He did not. Foul ball. Ethan Stringer nearly made a circus catch, and the ball dropped foul as he went crashing into the wall down there. And Greg Appleton going to come out. Conversation going on between third base coach Patrick Collins and the third base umpire who made the call, Bobby Dunnigan. Appleton going to the home plate umpire, now going to Dunnigan. And he's saying, okay, we'll talk about it. And they're going to bring all the umpires in. Third base umpire had the best look. Third base coach Patrick Collins still talking, and now all four umpires getting together. We've seen this a couple of times today. If it stands as called, it's a one ball, two strike count. If it is overturned and ruled a hit, a run will score, and they'll have runners at first and third, at least the way hitters and runners are aligned now. Meadows, meanwhile, is back at the plate. Actually, that's where the runners were to begin things. So they have all gone back to their respective spots. So where do you put them? If you make the ruling now, where do you put them? Do you call it a ground rule double and put a runners at second and third and a run in? Conversation continuing, and it is a foul ball. So holding it 1-2 on Meadows. So Tobinsey and the Crusaders, for the moment anyway, dodge a bullet, but he's still got to get David Meadows. One ball and two strikes. Derek Wiley on deck. Lefty with the paws and the 1-2 pitch. And it's fouled off to the right this time out of play. Holding it 1-2 on Meadows. Runners on the corners, two down, a run in. 7-3 North Greenville. Columbus State batting the pitch. Upstairs, 2-2. Deuces wild here. Two balls, two strikes, two on and two out. Tobinsey trying to shut it down. Meadows trying to keep it going. Break-even pitch. Outside, ball three. So Minner will be on the move from first with two outs and a full count. Boughton will be running on contact from third if there is contact. And again, the dangerous Derek Wiley in the on-deck circle. Three balls, two strikes. There goes the runner from first, and it's high ball four. He walked him. Second walk of the inning, and they're loaded up for Wiley. Wiley has been up twice. Both times he has struck out swinging. He can make this a one. Actually, he can tie this thing up with one swing of the bat. Hunter Dilworth, the pitching coach, coming out of the dugout to talk to his young left-hander. So that's what the error and the walk. You look at the inning. Walk to Curley leading off. Errant pickoff throw got him around to third. Boughton hit by a pitch. Brabson strikes out. Brooks an RBI ground out to make it 7-3. And then Metter hit a ground ball wide of third that Monteith got moving off to his left. Easy throw. I say easy throw, a throw that college athlete at this level, and Monteith himself will tell you he should have made. Instead, it was in the dirt. Kept the inning alive. Meadows walks to load the bases, and now all of a sudden, after jumping out to a 6-0 lead, North Greenville and Chewy Tobinsey are facing the tying run at the plate here in the fifth inning. And Derek Wiley has struck out swinging twice. Tobinsey, a long look into Jax Cash, ready to go to work. And the first pitch is swung on and popped foul. That'll get back out of play, 0-1. Cougar runners at every base with two outs here in the fifth. Tobinsey with the 0-1 pitch. Swing and a miss. Looked like a changeup down and away, and Wiley went fishing. 0-2. Tobinsey struck him out in the last inning with a high fastball, but if you're going to do that again, you better elevate it. He's in the driver's seat here at 0-2, pitching, and he did come upstairs while he started, stopped, took it for a ball, 1-2. Wynn Johns on deck. Wiley, the seventh man to bat in the inning. Tobinsey comes set. His 1-2 pitch, and a ground ball up the middle. There is Octavio to his left, fields and throws, inning is over. Was playing behind the bag, had to move off to his left a bit. And all things considered, Tobinsey does a nice job. They get a run unearned, no hits in the inning, two errors, three runners left, halfway through the finale of this one. 7-3 North Greenville. Bottom of the fifth, Leo Giannone gave up an unearned run when he came on in the fourth. They got it back at the top of the fifth, so still a four-run game, 7-3 North Greenville. Zara, Kaminsky, and Cash, 6-7-8 against the submarining right-hander. Zara's 0-2, and he grounds this one over the mound, backhanded by the second baseman, McDade. His throw is offline. And that should be an infield single, and it is. Ranging far to his right, near, well, it was behind the second base bag and had to make an off-balance throw. And it was offline, and Zara with a leadoff base hit. Now Kaminsky, who has walked and scored and struck out in two times up, getting the start at DH in this one after Jordan Holliday started the first two. And Kaminsky takes a breaking ball low, ball one. Giannone with the pause in the pitch. And got in on him a little bit there, and he fouled it back. Ball and a strike. Seven, 7-2 for North Greenville. 3-4-2 for Columbus State. Throw to first, and diving back is Zara. Ball and a strike. Giannone pitching, and the breaking ball up and out. 2-1. One pitch. Runner goes. Pitch is taken for a strike. The throw down, and he is out a mile. Oh, he caught him safe. He must have got in the back door. Throw looked like it was there in time. From where I'm sitting, maybe he missed the tag. I don't know. But no argument at all. So a stolen base for Zara. He's now 5-for-5 on the season. 2-2 the count on Kaminsky, and here you go, runner in scoring position again with nobody out. Break-even pitch, and Kaminsky stays alive with a foul ball back. Two and two on Andrew Kaminsky with Jax Cash on deck. Giannone with the pause and the pitch. And it's fouled off again, so Kaminsky making him work. Fouling off pitch after pitch. Here's another look. Man, he just got in the back door, beat the tag. Good close-up camera work from our high home plate camera. Nice job, guys. Watching it live from here without that close-up, it looked like the throw was there in time. And a bluff back. Two and two. Kaminsky waiting. Giannone pitching. And another foul. So Kaminsky battling right now. Two balls and two strikes. It's fouled off. Multiple pitches, and now did they just call a balk on Giannone? No, they didn't. He stepped off first. Not sure what they're warning him about. But he stepped off. Home plate umpire Trevor Henson wrote something down in his little notepad. He's made multiple notes today. 2-2 pitch again. And strike three called, a breaking ball. Locked him up. Kaminsky, you could tell he wanted to swing. couldn't, and he gets called out on strikes. So, again, at the very least, you want to get the runner to third there. Kaminsky can't do it, and now Jax Cash, who's walked and scored and flied to center. That is the second strikeout for Giannone. First pitch to Cash is hit the other way into right field, a base hit. They're going to bring Zara around. Here comes the throw to the plate. It is way offline and high. Zara scores. Cash delivers. It's 8-3, and he moves up to second on the throw to the plate. I mean, that bad boy from Wiley airmailed the catcher. And fortunately for Columbus State, Giannone was where he was supposed to be, backing up the play. He caught that thing on the fly. Now Corey Bivens, bases loaded, walk to drive in a run, add a single and scored a run in the last inning. He didn't hit it hard, Jax Cash, but they were shading him up the middle with the second baseman, and he dribbled it through that big hole on the right side. Lead is 5, runner at second, still just one out, and a slow roller left side. Meadows tried to make the tag on the runner at third, dropped the ball, and all hands are safe. Cash nearly ran into an out. That'll be a fielder's choice for Bivens, and Cash advances to third on the error by Meadows. They're on the corners with one out, and back to the top of the order for Octavio, who's 2-for-3. Well, you go back to the first game, Meadows in the late innings juggled a couple of balls and was able to recover and get outs. And that time he tried to swipe tag Bivens as he went by. I don't know if he made contact with him or not. But regardless, the ball came out, and everybody's safe, and Octavio's down a strike. Two hits in the first inning, a run scored and two RBIs. He struck out against Giannone in the fourth. And a throw over, and he throws it away. That'll score the runner Cash from third. And on to second goes Bivens. It's 9-3. Boy, this is starting to take on the look of the winner-take-all regional championship against Lenoir Rhine when the Bears committed 6 errors in that game. That's 4 errors now. 2 of them in this inning for Columbus State. It's a 9-3 lead. They've got the 6-run lead back to the Crusaders. Bivens at second, and Octavio almost hit by that pitch. How he contorted his body out of the way is a feat in and of itself. 1-1 the count. So still a long way to go in this one, but how big now does Matthew Tobin see getting out of the top of this fifth inning with only that one run scoring look? They had Wiley at the plate representing the tying run. He got him for the final out of the inning, and now 2 runs have scored, both unearned. And it's 2-1 count to Octavio, now 3-1 as Giannone misses outside. Interesting thing is, all of these runs could still end up being earned. Actually, I take that back. They can't, because there should have been an out on the Bivens ground ball, and there wasn't. Although, again, that would have been just a second out of the inning. And there's ball 4, and the bases are runners are first and second. Octavio on for the third time. And now Ethan Stringer. He's been on twice, both times via error. It's also flied to center. 0 for 3 officially. They've had a pitcher warming up in their bullpen. He's just watching right now. 9-3, North Greenville, still just one out in the inning, and Stringer at the plate with runners at first and second. And he lines it back through the middle. Center field, base hit. Here comes Bivens to score. Octavio on his way to third. He is in with a head first slide. RBI base hit for Stringer. It is 10-3 North Greenville. That'll make the Zara run earned. Cash and Bivens runs are unearned, and here comes Appleton. And that's going to be all for Giannone. We got a break in the action. 10-3 North Greenville. Back in a moment. New pitcher for Columbus State is right-hander Zach Brockman, a 6'1", 180-pound senior from Savannah, Georgia, by way of Liberty University. Brockman, 18th appearance, all in relief, 3-0, a 470 earned run average. 23 innings, 23 hits, 14 runs, 12 earned. 16 strikeouts, 10 walks, and opponents hitting 261 against him. Giannone, inning in a third, five hits, four runs. At the moment, only one of those earned. A walk and two strikeouts. Brockman will come on to face Pat Monteith with runners at first and second and still just one out in the inning. The only out, the called third strike on Kaminsky. Runners on the corners. And Monteith, a three-run home run. He's been hit by a pitch and has an infield single. So Brockman ready to go to work. Monteith waiting. And the first pitch is a good breaking ball for a strike. Brockman with the pause at the letters and the 0-1. He bounced it up there, and that will allow Stringer to advance to second base. Good block by Brooks. Kept it in front of him, but wild pitch. Now a base hit means two more. Seven-run lead, the largest of the game for the Crusaders. They scored six in the first inning to go up 6-0. 6-2, 7-2, then 7-3, and now three runs in the inning make it 10-3. The 1-1, breaking ball down and away. Two balls and a strike. going to pull the infield in now in a seven-run game. Second and third, one out, and Monteith takes a breaking ball low and away, 3-1 the count. Mark Kloop in the on-deck circle. Let's see what Monteith gets here. Three balls and a strike. Brockman bringing it, and he walked him. Missed low. And the bases are loaded for Mark Kloop. He has singled, bounced into a 4-6-3 double play, and has an RBI ground out. He has an opportunity here to blow this baby wide open. It's already 10-3. Teammates at every base and just one out in the inning. Brockman, the fourth pitcher of the afternoon. We are just in the bottom of the fifth. Here's the pitch to Kloop. And he was going for the downs and comes up empty. Strike one. Eighth man to bat in the inning. Just the one out. Three hits, two walks, two errors. The 0-1. And he fouls it out of play right side. It's no balls and two strikes. And again, I qualify this by reminding you, as we have seen in both of these games previous to this one, there's still a long way to go. But the hope is, if North Greenville gets to next weekend at the College World Series, they'll have John Michael Fail back in a DH capacity. Breaking ball down and in. And also, hopefully, Nate Roof, who is one of the main cogs out of their bullpen, who's out with mono. He is a little less likely, but they believe that Fail could play next weekend as a DH. 1-2 on Kloop. Got to get there first. And a line drive that nearly took the pitcher's head off, and this is going to be a double play. 4-6-3, fielded on a hop by McDade, and the inning is over. That's the second time that he has scorched one like that and had it turn into a 4-6-3 double play. But three runs in the inning. Eight men come to the plate. And after five complete, 10-3 North Greenville. Matthew Tobinsey back out for his third inning of relief work. He'll get the bottom third of the order, Johns, McDade, and Curley. Gave up an unearned run in the last inning, but man, did he get a big out of Derek Wiley, an inning that very easily could have fallen apart after the error by Monteith, but he limited the damage to just the one run. And when Johns swings through a changeup, 0-1. Wiley was at the plate at the time in a 7-3 game with the bases loaded, representing the tying run. And he grounded out the second. North Greenville adds three more. They lead it 10-3. That pitch is high. Some dark clouds have settled over the old ball orchard here. Good for the broadcaster because the sun is not in my eyes. Fly ball back into center. Josh Center getting back, camping, catching, one out. Now McDade, two-run homer, and a fly ball to center in his two times up. We're just at the top of the sixth inning, folks, so despite a seven-run differential, I would not suggest going anywhere based on what we've seen in the first two games of this series. First pitch is a breaking ball for a strike. Right-handed batter. And that one's a little bit low. Trying to zero my binoculars in on Jeff Massey's radar gun to see if I can pick up what the velocity was, and I can't get it to come in. 1-1 pitch, high and away. 2-1. One out, nobody on, top of the sixth. Columbus State batting. They are trailing North Greenville 10-3. In this winner-take-all third game of the Southeast Super Regional. Swing and a miss. 2-0 changeup and got him fishing. 2-2. Pop foul out of play right side. I want to say hello to Doug Deerdorf, watching from Florida, his son Carter. Is a commit to North Greenville. Boy, that pitch just a bit up in the opinion of home plate umpire Trevor Henson, 3-2. Says you do an amazing job of covering both the color and the call of the game. Doug, you are now officially my agent. Thank you very much. 3-2 the count. Payoff pitch. Fouled right back at us. I had hoped that my Greenville Drive broadcast partner, Tom Van Hoy, was going to be able to work with me on this series, but Tom got called to do the Wednesday and Friday games, strike three swinging in the Southern Conference tournament. So he had the choice of getting paid for eight games or three, and he took the eight. You get nothing and like it. Chop liver, exactly. Two down. My good friend Nick Dittmar. I don't know. It's the fine line between keeping me company and pestering me in the booth here. Here's Connor Curley, 0-1 with a walk and a run scored. Tobinsey's first pitch to him, breaking ball strike. Started the swing, held up, and it cost him anyway. 0-1. Two down. Nobody on, 10-3. North Greenville on top. The 0-1 popped him up. Third baseman Monteith coming down toward the plate in foul or fair territory. Inning is over. Three up and three down for Tobinsey. And in the middle of the sixth, it remains North Greenville on top. 10-3. We'll be back in a moment. Thank you. No balls and a strike to Josh Center leading it off here in the bottom of the sixth. He's 0 for 2 with a walk. Brockman, who came on to get out of the last inning for Columbus State, starting this inning, misses with a breaking ball, 1 and 1. Checks the swing on a pitch down. Two balls and a strike. 10-3. North Greenville leads it here in the sixth inning. Brockman working from the stretch, the 2-1. Fastball in there for a strike. 2-2. Center Zara and Kaminsky due up here in the inning. 2-2 pitch. Strike three swinging. Fastball away. Center couldn't catch up to it, and there's one out. First strikeout for Brockman. And now Zara led off the last inning with the infield single and scored the first of the three runs. Left-handed batter. And the first pitch down and in a ball. The 1-0 lays off another pitch down and in. Two balls and no strikes. And a big swing and a foul off the support pole. Ricochets halfway up the first baseline, three quarters of the way up the first baseline. Two balls and a strike. Pitch to Zara. Low 3-1. See what he gets here. Here comes the 3-1 pitch. Got a fastball up and out over the plate, and he fouled it back. 3-2. So a payoff pitch coming from Brockman to Zara. One out deep into the bottom of the sixth. Here it is. And a looping line drive foul. Beyond third, down the left field line. So we'll do the payoff all over again. Brockman again ready with the 3-2. And he missed down and in ball four. So Zara on for the second straight time. Second walk issued by Brockman since coming on. And now Kaminsky, who walked and scored in the first inning, since then has struck out swinging and looking. But looks like he's going to be taken down. And yesterday's game one hero, Bryce Roddy, is going to come off the bench to pinch hit. Roddy also pinch hit in the first game today. Roddy hit an 0-2 pitch into left center field to drive in the game-winning run in the bottom of the 10th inning last night. And in the first game today, Pinch hitting in the eighth inning, a fielder's choice ground ball. He's pinch hitting here in the sixth for Kaminsky. Left-handed batting freshman. And the first pitch to him is outside a ball. 353 in very limited time. 12 hits and 34 at-bats. 5 runs batted in. Landon Powell telling us in the postgame press conference yesterday he recruited this kid because he can hit. Breaking ball, 1-1. And it's been an interesting dynamic for Roddy, who, as most high school players who get to the college level, played every day, and he's having to sit for the first time behind Garrick Octavio here in his freshman season. And talked to him about preparing and being ready in that situation last night. And he credited Coach Trey Dyson for just telling him to make sure he's always prepared, as if he's going to start, always ready to swing the bat if called on. He fouls it back, 2-2. Sun breaking out from behind the clouds momentarily. 2-2 on Roddy. Zara at first, one down, bottom of the sixth, 10-3 North Greenville. Southeast Super Regional, third and deciding game. 2-2 pitch, runner goes, and Roddy strikes out swinging. Throw down on a hop is late. Stolen base for Zara, his second of the game. Roddy down on strikes for the second out. 2 strikeouts in the inning for Brockman, and now Jax Cash, who had an RBI base hit in the last inning. 1-for-2 with a walk. He has scored twice. Finally settling into the batter's box. Brockman will bluff back to second. Zara was extending that lead with nobody close to the bag. First pitch, breaking ball inside corner, a strike. Outfield straight away. Infield is back. No balls and a strike. Brockman's 0-1. Cash swings and misses. Tardy on a fastball down. He's behind 0-2. So no balls, 2 strikes with Zara out at second base and 2 down. The pitch, and it's in the air to right. Wiley backing a bit, got it, inning over. So the walk, he advances to second on the steal, that's it. And we've completed 6. 10-3 North Greenville. We'll be back in a moment. Six inning totals for North Greenville, 10 runs, 9 hits, 2 errors. They have stranded 7. And for Columbus State, 3 runs, 4 hits, 4 errors. They have left 6. Fourth pitcher of the day for North Greenville is right-hander Nathan Barrillet. Redshirt junior, 6'5", 185-pounder out of Myrtle Beach via Florence Darlington Tech. He follows Rodriguez, Skipper, and Tobinsey. Barrillet making his 14th appearance, all out of the bullpen, 1-1, a 4.02 earned run average, 15 and two-thirds innings, 12 hits, 7 runs earned, 16 strikeouts, 10 walks, opponents hitting 207 off of him. Tobinsey, 3 innings, 1 hit, 1 run, it was unearned, 2 walks, 3 strikeouts, and he hit a batter. So he did his job. It was a bit of a high wire act in the fifth inning, but then he bounced back and got him out in order in the sixth. So now it's Barrillet. Here in the top of the seventh, top of the order due up. Boughton, Brabston, and Brooks. Barrillet working from the stretch in his first pitch as a fastball swung on and fouled away. No balls and a strike. Boughton has bounced to first, fly to center, been hit by a pitch. Fastball strike, it's 0-2. No balls and two strikes. Right-hander bringing it. Just missed the outside corner. One ball and two strikes. Tried to paint it out there and didn't get the call. Close. Very close. One and two the count. Right-hander brings it. And he got in on him, popped it up behind the plate. Cash has a play. One out. And you get into that spot you were in the first game. If you're North Greenville, you start counting down the outs. This time, though, it's a 7-run lead as opposed to a 2-run lead. We've seen both teams in this series win games with dramatic late inning heroics, so you take nothing for granted until you get that 27th and final out. Colby Brabston, 1-for-3. One for 12 in the series. Takes it outside. A ball, had an infield single in the first. They're in the shift for him, Octavio, about 15 feet out in short right field for the left-handed batter, and Barrillet misses high. Two balls and no strikes. Swinging a foul, 2-1. Actually, this is not Brabston at the plate. This is the pinch hitter, Will Wilbanks, who we saw in the first game. And he takes it down and away, 3-1. He had a pinch hit single to give them two runners on, and he was on base when Boughton launched the game-winning home run. 3-1 to the left-handed batter. And there's ball four. Didn't miss by much. So one out walk, and now Robert Brooks. One for three, got his first hit of the series in the third inning. He's one for 10, has driven in a run with a ground ball. He did that in the fifth. Barrelet ready to go to work on him in the first pitch. Breaking ball, misses low and away, ball one. They're in the shift. So Octavio directly behind second base. A couple of steps back on the outfield turf. The 1-0. Laid off a breaking ball low and away. Two balls and no strikes. You don't want to start nibbling and put runners on. You want to make them hit their way on if you're Nathan Barrelet. The 2-0, low ball three. Action out in the bullpen beyond the left field fence for North Greenville. Again, he can't see, but it looks like it's Herlong. Barrelet's 3-0, and he almost hit him, ball four. So back walks here in the seventh inning. Brings Stephen Minner to the plate. And that is Herlong warming up, thanks to the camera shot. Minner 0 for 3, reached on an error his last time up. So Barrelet pitching himself into some difficulty here. Seven-run lead. He's walked back-to-back hitters with one out. And there's ball one to Brooks. And now Cash, the catcher, going to go out and talk with him. So is Landon Powell. Landon might have seen enough here. He's looking out that way. He hasn't signaled yet, but we'll see. He went out earlier and didn't make a change. He's got his entire infield gathered around him. It's catcher Jax Cash. And the conversation continuing. Home plate umpire Trevor Henson headed out that way. Circles up the first base side of the mound and says, all right, Landon, what are you going to do? He's going to leave Barrelet in. So, one ball and no strikes after back-to-back one-out walks. Cleanup hitter Stephen Minner, 70 runs batted in on the season, 14 homers. Another one of the dangerous guys in this batting order. The 1-0, and he bounced it up there and gets away, and both runners are going to advance. Things going from bad to worse for Nathan Barrelet right now. I mean, you want to make them hit their way on, not make it easy for them to try to scratch back into the game. But I always remind people that it's an easy game from up here. The 2-0. Low ball three, and he's a pitch away from loading the bases. I think, in fact, Mickey Mantle once said that he didn't realize how easy the game was until he got into the broadcast booth. 3 balls and no strikes. You know he's taking here. And he walked him. Didn't come close. That loads him up for David Meadows. And here comes Landon Powell, and this time Nathan Barrelett's going to come back with him. So a break in the action as a pitching change is in the offing. Brent Herlong going to come out of the bullpen. We will tell you about him in just a moment. Brent Herlong, the graduate from Lakeview, South Carolina, 6'3", 205, second appearance in the series, pitched an inning in the opener yesterday, allowed two hits and a run, no walks or strikeouts. And he has been outstanding out of North Greenville bullpen, 28th appearance, two more now than Tristan Hudson. 7-1, 2.15 ERA with a save. 40 strikeouts to just 5 walks, and he will come at you with multiple arm angles. So he will face David Meadows with the bases loaded. One out. Columbus State down 7. Meadows has been on all 3 times, 2 walks and a bunt single. And Herlong's first pitch on the outside corner of strike. Those 3 walks, North Greenville pitching has issued a total of 6 today. 2 of them have scored. 2 of the first 3. There's a strike on the inside corner, and Meadows takes exception to that call by home plate umpire Trevor Henson. 0-2. And the sun is back out full force here at Ray and B. Dillard Field. No balls and 2 strikes. Herlong pitching, and he misses outside with a breaking ball. One and 2. Cougars at every base with 1 out here in the top of the 7th. They're trying to rally, trailing North Greenville 10-3. Herlong, a good long look into his catcher, now ready with the 1-2 pitch to Meadows. And he spins one up there, and it misses outside. 2-2. Derek Wiley on deck. Will Banks at third, Brooks at second, Minner at first. They all walked. 2-2 pitch, grounded back up the middle. Octavio flips to Bivens for one on to first. Double play, inning over. Hit it hard, but Octavio was shading him towards second. And it was an easy 4-6-3 double play. And just like that, the inning is over. No hits, two left. Seventh inning stretch, 10-3 North Greenville. Bottom of the seventh inning and a new pitcher for Columbus State, their fifth. It is right-hander Austin Elliott. He's a 6'3 senior, 185-pounder out of Alexander City, Alabama. Started his career at Mount Olive. Made the move here. He's been exceptional for them out of the bullpen this season. 25th appearance, 1-0, 273 earned run average. 29 and two-thirds innings, 32 hits, 14 runs, just 9 earned. 34 strikeouts, 16 walks, and the opponent's hitting 262 against him. Zach Brockman inning in two-thirds. No runs, no hits, 2 strikeouts, 2 walks. So it will be Elliott leading off this inning, or pitching this inning, to the number 9 hitter, Corey Bivens, leading it off. And then back to the top of the order for Octavio and Stringer. Bivens has driven in a run today with a bases loaded walk. He scored twice, 1-for-2 officially. And Austin Elliott ready to go to work on the Crusaders shortstop. First pitch, breaking ball down and away, ball one. Right-handed batter waiting, and he tried to hold up on the swing and could not. One ball, one strike. Line drive back through the middle, fielded on the short hop by the second baseman, and McDade throws him out. Was shading him that way, made a nifty little play, one away. Now Octavio, 2-for-3 with a walk, Both of his hits came in the first inning when he scored once and drove in two. Only time they got him out in the fourth, he struck out swinging. He walked his last time. And he takes the first pitch, a strike. Ten, 9-2 for North Greenville. 3-4-4. 4-4. For Columbus State, Octavio fouls it off. He's behind 0-2. The four errors have played a big role in this. Only three of North Greenville's 10 runs are earned runs. And as I said, it looks an awful lot like the finals of the region when they beat Lenoir Rhine. Lenoir Rhine made six errors in that game. Breaking ball down and in, 1-2. Of course, you have to be able to take advantage of them, and they've done that in various forms. One-two pitch. Pounding ball to the right side. There's the first baseman to the pitcher covering, and not in time. Octavio beat him there. Men are feeding Elliott, and a bang-bang play at first base, and Octavio got there just a flash ahead of the Cougar pitcher. His third hit of the game. He's a one-out base runner for Ethan Stringer. Octavio's been on four times now. Stringer 1-for-4. He's been on two other times via error, has an RBI and a score to run. And first pitch swinging, he shoots it off of the facing of the near end of the first base dugout. No balls and a strike. Ball low, 1-1. Ten, 3, North Greenville, batting in the bottom of the seventh inning. Winner take all, third and deciding game of the Super Regional. And a foul ball right side out of play. 1-2. As we detailed at the top of the day, way back at the beginning of game one today, game two of the series, first game today, it would be North Greenville's first D2 College World Series appearance in school history. High fly ball, deep, left field, way back, goodbye, home run Ethan Stringer. His sixth of the season, a two-run shot in the seventh. It's 12-3 Crusaders. Wynn Johns took two or three steps and just turned and watched that baby sail out of here. Three RBIs in the game, give him 37 on the year. It is a 9-run Crusader lead, and they're starting to smell that first World Series appearance just a little bit more. Now Pat Monteith, been on all four times, a 3-run homer. He's been hit by a pitch, infield single, and a walk. Takes ball one. Strike two, or strike one called. Slider on the outside corner. 1-1. Stay back. There's a strike called. 1-2. Mark Kloop waiting on deck. 1-2 pitch. And it's lined right to the third baseman, Meadows, two out. Hit it hard, but right to his opposite number. And now two down for Mark Kloop. The two hardest balls he has hit today, both of them he scorched, have both been turned into 4-6-3 double plays. He's 1-for-4. Singled and scored in the first, drove in a run with a ground ball in the fourth. And then the two double play ground balls. First pitch from Elliott, swing and a miss on a breaking ball that couldn't have hit with a boat paddle. 0-1. Elliott brings it. Another swing and a miss at a slider. No balls and two strikes. Two down, nobody on, bottom of the seventh. Two-run homer by Stringer's made it 12-3, and there's a base hit into center field. Shot it right back over the mound. Kloop's second hit of the game. Twelfth hit overall. And now Josh Center, 0-for-3 with a walk, a pair of strikeouts. Elliott's first pitch, breaking ball outside, ball one. Right-hander brings it. Checked his swing on a pitch way outside. Two balls and no strikes. Kloop at first. Two down, two runs in. 12-3 North Greenville here in the seventh. Strike calling on the inside corner, 2-1. Zach Zara would be next. 2-1 pitch, runner goes, swing and a miss. Throw down to second, late. Also a little bit to the first base side. Kloop with his second stolen base of the game. 29 on the season now. He's been caught twice. And it's 2-2 on Josh Center. Break even pitch to him from Elliott. And a fly ball into left field. That's going to drop for a base hit in front of Johns. Scoring is Kloop, and into second on the throw goes Josh Center. Didn't have enough air under it for Johns to get there. RBI number 52 for Josh Center. It's a 13-3 game. Zach Zara, 1-for-3 with a walk and a run scored. Left-handed batter, and he swings at the first pitch and comes up empty. No balls and a strike. The 0-1. Bounced up there. Good stop by Brooks. Austin Elliott, the fifth pitcher of the afternoon. Greenville has, North Greenville has also used five. 1-2, or 1-1 pitch. And a high bounding ball to the second baseman. McDade had to wait on the second hop, hung with it, and throws out Zara. That's a lot more difficult play than it looked, especially because of the turf. But three runs in the inning, two of them on Stringer's homer. And after seven complete, it is 13-3, Crusaders.
Their support enhances NCAA championships and the educational and athletic experiences of nearly half a million student athletes.
Brent Herlong came in the seventh with the bases loaded and one out and got David Meadows to ground into a 4-6-3 double play. So he is out there to begin the eighth inning. 13-3 Crusaders, six outs away from a historic first ever College World Series appearance for this program. Herlong finishes his warm-ups. Cassius throw down to second, and it'll be Wiley, Johns, and McDade, 6, 7, and 8. Derek Wiley, 0 for 3. Two strikeouts and a ground ball to second. The last two times he's been up, he has made critical outs with the bases loaded. Herlong's first pitch to him is a breaking ball that floats in for a strike. Herlong winds in the 0-1. Breaking ball drops in. It's no balls and two strikes. Oh and two. The pitch. Grounded by the mound, past the diving shortstop. Bivens into left center field for a base hit. So Wiley on for the first time. Just the fifth hit they've had in this game. And now Will Johns, 0 for 3. Two fly balls and a fielder's choice ground out. Chops it towards Bivens, takes it to the bag himself for one, running throw, double play. 6-3, two down. Moving off to his left, his momentum taking him toward the bag in a hurry. No need to flip it to Octavio. He just did it himself. Now McDade hit the two-run homer in the second inning. Since then, a fly ball to center and a strikeout swinging. First pitch from Herlong is a breaking ball outside. North Greenville. Top of the eighth, two outs, nobody on for Columbus State. Swing and a miss on another breaking ball, 1-1. 1-1 pitch. Fly ball deep center field. Josh Center warning track wall reaching up, and he makes the catch. Just a step or show or step or so shy of the wall. Day gave it a ride, but Center runs it down. A hit, nobody left. Middle of the eighth, 13-3 Crusaders. Bottom of the eighth inning, North Greenville coming to bat for what they hope will be the final time, and leading by 10, it should be. But again, you never know. And they'll be hitting off of the sixth pitcher of the afternoon, the closer, fine young right-handed sophomore Peyton Burton, Phenix City, Alabama. Saw him yesterday, and he blew the save in the ninth inning. And ended up taking the loss. And they scored, the Crusaders did, the unearned run in the 10th. That doesn't take away from the overall year this kid has had. He has been outstanding. 27 previous appearances, all in relief, 4-2, 236 earned run average, 5 saves. He replaces Elliott, who went an inning, 4 hits, 3 runs earned, no walks or strikeouts. Bryce Roddy batting for the second time. And he takes the pitch off the plate for ball one from Burton. The 1-0, swing and a miss. Roddy has had 3 at-bats in this super regional prior to this plate appearance, but the one he's always going to remember, and if things continue as they are, barring a collapse of biblical proportions in the top of the ninth inning, his legend is going to always be providing that game-winning single on an 0-2 pitch in the 10th inning to drive in the winning run that won the first game of the Super Regional and capped that unlikely comeback. 2 balls and 2 strikes to him. Jax Cash, Corey Bibbins also due up in the inning. And it's fouled off to the left, out of play. Two and two the count. Burton, pitcher number 6. And Roddy lifts it into left center field. It's going to hang up, though, and Wynn Johns, the left fielder, coming a long way to make the running catch. One down. And again, barring something just off the charts happening. Matthew Tobinsey, been told by the official scorekeeper, the third of 5 pitchers will get credit for the win. And the starter, Devin Doodall, who only went an inning and gave up 6 runs, would take the loss. Only 2 of those runs were earned. For Tobinsey, it would run his record to 3-2 on the season. He pitched 3 innings, gave up just an unearned run. Pitched out of a big-time mess in the fifth. Partially his own doing, partially some defensive issues. But gave up just the one run and got Wiley on a ground ball to second with the bases loaded and two outs when he was at the plate representing the tying run. It was 7-3 at the time. He pitched a scoreless and perfect sixth. And the offense for the Crusaders has tacked on six more runs. They lead it 13-3. 2-1 on Jax Cash. Fly ball to right. Here comes Wiley. Two down. Now Corey Bivens. He's been in the middle of things today. 1-for-3 officially, a walk. That came with the bases loaded in the first to drive in a run. He has scored twice. Batting with two outs and nobody on here in the bottom of the eighth. And Burton starts him off with a strike. Looking ahead for Columbus State, 9-1-2 due up. Curley, Boughton, and Wilbanks. Breaking ball, strike two called. It's no balls and two strikes. Burton pitching, and he just got a piece, did Bivens, to hang around. Holding it 0-2. Right-hander brings it. Struck him out swinging. Chase the slider down and away. Inning is over. Three up and three down. We go to the ninth. The Crusaders three outs away from school history, leading at 13-3. North Greenville, three outs away from school history. Brent Herlong came on in the seventh, got a bases loaded ground ball double play to get out of the inning, gave up a hit, but another double play in the eighth. 9-1-2, Connor Curley leading it off, and a strike on the outside corner. Curley, 0-for-2 with a walk and a run scored. The 0-1. Line drive into center. Josh Center there, one out. Playing him shallow. Easily made the catch. Two outs away. Here's Isaac Boughton. He's the reason we are playing this third game of this Super Regional. His one-out, three-run home run in the bottom of the ninth inning earlier today in Game 2 gave Columbus State a 4-3 win. In this one, 0-for-3, he's been hit by a pitch. Fouled out to the catcher his last time up. Strike one called. For North Greenville, it has been quite the journey to get on the precipice of this moment. They've never been to the Division II College World Series. Back in 2011, they won the National Christian College Athletic Association World Series. One ball and one strike. In 2014, the year before Landon Powell got here, this program won a grand total of 8 games. Strike two called on the inside corner. In Powell's first season in 2015, none of what we're seeing here as far as this facility is concerned was anywhere near what it is now. They won the Conference Carolinas tournament and went to the NCAA regionals. Since then, they have done everything you can do as a program except get to the College World Series. They are two outs away from doing that here today. The 2-2 pitch, and Boughton fouls it off to the right, out of play. During that time, the facility upgrades, the all-turf field, this nice press box and broadcast facility that we are in, the baseball building, all of this has been built here through money and support that's been raised and has turned the baseball program at this small private Christian school in northern Greenville County, South Carolina, into one of the preeminent D2 programs in the country. Fouled out of play right side. The only thing missing from that resume is getting to and then ultimately winning a College World Series. But before you can get, or before you can win it, you got to get to it. They're two outs away from doing just that. Hurlong with the 2-2 again. And strike three called on the inside corner, two down. They're one out away. First strikeout for Hurlong. And the North Greenville fans here coming to their feet as Will Wilbanks, who pinch hit and walked in the seventh inning, will come to the plate. They'll go into the shift for him. And Hurlong will work from the windup. First pitch of the left-handed batter is flared down behind third, but a foul ball. Strike one. Columbus State, they are wrapping up a marvelous season in their own right. Coming into the Super Regional, ninth in the country, Greg Appleton. In his 25th season, going to fall just short of a fifth College World Series appearance. They won it back in 2002. Runner-up in 07 and 12. They've been to the NCAAs 12 times since he's been there, but they're down to their final strike. Hurlong looks into Cash. Winds in the 0-2 pitch, and he bounced it up there. Ball and two strikes. Should Will Banks reach, Robert Brooks would be next. 13-3, North Greenville, two outs, top of the ninth inning. Trying to put it away with this pitch is the graduate right-hander, Brent Hurlong. Here it comes, and it's fouled at the plate. He just got a piece, and Cash couldn't hold on. They had jumped the railing in the third base dugout, were ready for the dog pile, and they had to go right back in, holding it 1-2. Will Banks waiting. Hurlong, calm, cool, and collected. Winds, and again the 1-2 pitch. Fastball outside. He dropped down sidearm on him. 2-2 the count. Game is exactly 3.5 hours old. As Herlong readies for the 2-2 pitch, here it comes. And it's grounded right side. Octavio, he'll throw to Herlong, and he threw it away. Herlong was late getting to the bag, and it goes into the dugout. Zara, who was playing deep, never broke to the bag, and Herlong had to get there, and the moment has been delayed for a moment. It'll be a throwing error on Garrick Octavio, and with it going into the dugout, that will allow Will Banks to make his way to second base. So Robert Brooks, who has one hit in this series, young man who has had just an incredible career capped by a senior season that saw him come into play yesterday hitting .394. Was at .381 coming in to this one. He's 1-for-3 with an RBI. 84 runs batted in, 21 home runs. And he takes a breaking ball on the inside corner, a strike. So the big moment delayed at least one more hitter. Herlong sets the 0-1 sidearm fastball. Bounding ball, Zara, he'll take it to the bag himself. And there you go. History in Tigerville. The North Greenville Crusaders are going to the College World Series for the first time in school history with a 13-3 win in the third and deciding game of this Super Regional over Columbus State. The dog pile up along the first baseline. It is a happy bunch of red-jerseyed Crusaders who are now up off the turf, and the hugs are going on all around. The tournament director already standing behind home plate with the trophy waiting for somebody to come and accept it. But this is a moment that has been, well, forever as far as the history of North Greenville baseball incoming. And for Landon Powell, who has been to the College World Series as a member of the South Carolina Gamecocks at the Division I level, one of the all-time top 50 players in the Rosenblatt Stadium era of the College World Series, has now reached the playoffs, the College World Series, and Cary, North Carolina as the head coach of this North Greenville program. Final score again, 13-3. Crusaders win it. They improve to 50-10 on the season. And Columbus State will finish its year at 46 up and 13 down. Trophy presentation now being made behind home plate. There's the replay of the dog pile. Jax Cash, Zach Zara getting tackled by the entire dugout. And look at those smiles. Brent Herlong and Josh Center, two guys who have been around here for a long, long time, accepting the trophy. And now they take it back to the rest of the team in front of the mound. And the celebration continues here at Ray and B. Dillard Field. Final score, North Greenville wins it 13-3. And we'll advance to next week's College World Series in Cary, North Carolina, that begins on June the 4th. Hope you enjoyed the broadcast. I have enjoyed a second year of getting to bring you some of these North Greenville University baseball games. And good luck to Landon Powell and his club as they head to Cary for the D2 College World Series. Final score again, North Greenville 13. And Columbus State 3. The Crusaders win the Southeast Super Regional 2-1. For everybody here at North Greenville, for the camera guys, the production guys, the game ops people, everybody, I'm Dan Scott saying God bless you and so long, everybody.